Today we're going to be going over a new series of tips for Illustrator after my last video was such a hit. You can check out my first Illustrator tips video. I'll put a link up in the top right-hand corner for you. But today we're going to be going through an updated list of some new tips we've got for Adobe Illustrator. So we're just going to dive straight in, and I just want to give a quick tip at the start of the video and show you how I create a new file. So once you go up into the top left-hand corner and go File, New File. So I normally go straight to Print because most of the things that I'm working on are going to be printed, and this makes certain that you're in the CMYK color space, which is what you want for printing. I make sure my artboard is set to landscape orientation. Today I'll use A4. I change the units to millimeters because that's what makes most sense to me. I'll leave the raster effects and everything else as it is. Bleed I'll leave at zero. So you click create. So if anyone's workspace doesn't look like this, just quickly check out my original Illustrator video. I'll put the link up again. That goes through how I set up the workspace like I have them here. So the first tip we're going to be looking at is creating your own hatches. And what you can do is just quickly draw some lines roughly how you want. You can edit them later. So if you're doing like a little grass or a little stipple, once you've done that, just select them, go up the top menu to Object, Pattern, Make. And now you can see that's your pattern. I think these lines probably want to be a bit thinner, so I'll go up the top here and change that to just a 0.3. We might change the color. And if you click on the stroke, you can edit that further. So I might just do rounded edges and rounded corners. And then you can see that's not tiling that well. So what you might want to do is just select some of the individual pieces and move them. So you can just fiddle with that until you get something you're kind of happy with. If you want to draw some more things in, you can do that now. And then if you want to apply that, you just draw your shape and you can apply it in. And so that's a custom pattern, and you can just go ahead and apply that as you like. So the next tip is about creating your own arrows and dotted lines and dashed lines. So if you use the pen tool to just create some lines, maybe you've even got a curved line using the pen tool, and you want to make an arrow. What you do is you select that line and you go to your stroke properties window. So you can go either window, stroke, and then it will open out. I've actually already got it open, or you can click up here. So I've got the stroke window open down here, and you can see we've got some properties for arrowheads. You can just go through and select your arrowhead and apply that. So if you think the arrowhead's a bit small, you can change the scale of the arrowhead. So I might try 200%. If you'd like to switch the direction of the arrow, click the switch direction. And if you want to change the line weight of the line, you can, but that will affect the size of the head. If you'd like to have a dash line, just click on the dash line option, and then you can change the length of the dashes and then the gaps as well. So reduce the gaps, it'll get tighter. And if you wanted to have a line which has a shorter gap and then a longer gap, you can do that. Just play around with it until you get what you're happy with. So if you want to make a line that is dotted, as in round dots, what you do is you set the dash to zero, set the gap to whatever increment you like, increase the line weight, and change the end cap to rounded, and you'll have dots. And if you increase the line weight, the dots will get bigger. You might have to increase the gap, but play around with it. That's how you get a dotted line weight. Now, these are great for doing diagrams and site analysis, things like that. Now, when you look at the Pathfinder tool, this is essentially similar to things like Boolean or cut or split. So what you've got is merge, so that will turn them into one object. You've got Boolean remove, which removes the top object from the other object. If you want to change the position of an object in terms of whether it's above or below another object, select it, go right click, arrange, bring to front. And then if you click that, you can see it will cut out from the other object. You've also got intersection, which will give you just the intersection of the two objects and remove both parent objects. And then by contrast, you've got remove intersection, which deletes the intersection and unites the other two elements. Now let's say you wanted to remove this circle from all four of these squares. If you select all these objects and go Boolean, it doesn't work, it only works on one. So what you actually need to do is select all of these objects, turn them into a compound path. So right click, go make compound path, and then you can place the circle on those objects. And then what you can do is just click and it will take it out from the compound path. When you want to use the Pathfinder tool on multiple objects at once, make sure the objects are turned into a compound path and then complete the operation. So we're going to run through the commands you can use in the align window. If you would like to align left these squares so that their left edge is all aligned, you would click horizontal align left. If you wanted to align them on the right, you would click horizontal align right. And if you wanted to align them centrally, you would click horizontal align center. Now this also works vertically. So if you have three objects and you want to align top, you'd click align top, and that will align the top edge of all the objects. If you wanted to align bottom, it would align all of the objects with the lowest bottom of the objects. And if you align center, it would take the center line of the centermost object and align the objects based on that. When you look at the distribute objects command, these are related to distributing the spacing within the objects. If you wanted to distribute the spacing of these objects equally so that they have an equal gap, you would click the horizontal distribute and that would do that. If the objects were aligned vertically and you wanted to equalize the spacing, you would click the align vertical spacing. Now, all of these commands are really good for quickly aligning objects or changing ways in which they're oriented. I recommend you get familiar with this. It's quite a powerful tool and can seriously save you some time instead of having to individually drag objects to get them to align manually. So this next tip is going to be about how to make isometric items in Illustrator. So if you're creating an axonometric or isometric drawing and you want to quickly make, say, some massing buildings, what you can do is create a rectangle, go to Effect, 3D Materials, 3D Classic, Extrude and Bevel Classic. You want to change the position to isometric, play around with those to get it in the direction that you want, and you can change the extrude depth, which will affect the height of that object. You can scale this object, so you can make it wider or narrower and change its properties just by dragging these tooltips here. When you're happy, go to Object, Expand Appearance, and now you've got an editable shape, so you can go and recolor all of the faces. And if you wanted to create a shape that was different, so if we go back to, so you can see you can quickly generate a series of various different shapes and massing blocks, which are helpful for adding to your plans and diagrams all from Illustrator without having to necessarily do it in 3D modeling or CAD. So that's just a quick and dirty way to do that, and it's actually really good. Okay, that's it for today's video. Thanks everyone for watching, and feel free to pop a comment down below of anything that you'd like to see me cover in a future video, and I'll get straight to it. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.